I'm Miss Karen, the children's librarian from the Oakmont Carnegie Library in Allegheny Commons Park. We are celebrating Read Across America this week. It's a beautiful day outside, and this week I'm talking about different types of diversity and kindness. That's what Read Across America's theme is this week, this year. The book I'm reading is called Grow Kind. My name is Kiko. I grow kind. I will show you how, but first, I have a question for you. Who helped you wake up in the morning? This morning, Chico woke me up by licking my face. We went outside to check the garden. And I know we are all looking forward to having a garden soon, with the nice warm weather coming up. We saw peas and peaches, tomatoes and potatoes, radishes and roses, blackberries and broccoli, melons and marigolds, and so much more. I wanted to wake up Annie, but Mom and Dad stopped me. Be kind to Annie and let her rest, said Mom. Teenagers need a lot of sleep. I really wanted to show Annie everything growing in the garden, but I played fetch with Chico outside and waited for her to wake up. Finally, Annie woke up. You're up, you're up. I grabbed Annie's hand and pulled her toward the garden. Beautiful, Annie said. I know you worked hard caring for your garden. Do you need help to harvest? So Annie is being kind to her. Annie and I filled our arms with lots of yummy fruits and vegetables and some pretty flowers. I gave spinach, carrots, peppers, and broccoli to my dad because he likes to cook. Wonderful, he said. Thank you. The gift of veggies made my dad so happy, I wanted to share with other people too. Annie and I loaded up the wagon with food and flowers. Being kind to our friends and neighbors helps them feel good, I told Annie, and it helps you feel good too, said Annie. We pulled the heavy wagon down our street, delivering delicious gifts. Blackberries for Keisha, who loves sweet fruit. Soft, ripe tomatoes for Miss Stevens, who has a hard time chewing. Peppers and corn for our next door neighbors, Matt and Mitch, who love to grill. Potatoes for Dr. Thompson, who makes fresh potato salad. Sunflowers for Mr. Carroll, who needs cheering up. When we got to Mr. Carroll's house, we slowly walked to the front door. I was nervous. One time he shouted at Chico for running into his yard. But when Mr. Carroll opened the door, a smile lit up his face. Thank you both, he said. You're very kind. He gave Chico a gentle pat on the head. The next day I packed a box full of fruits and vegetables to share with my teacher and friends at school. But on the drive to school, I saw someone standing on the corner and I asked my mom if we could stop. I opened the box. What do you like to eat? I asked. Those peaches look delicious, she replied, and I gave her some. She waved as we said goodbye. She looks happy. During show and tell, I listened carefully to my friends. Ida brought her pet turtle. Dawn brought a jigsaw puzzle. Carmen brought her watercolor painting. When it was my turn, I said, I brought my garden. I gave everybody something to eat. It's show and tell and share. It made me feel so good to see everyone enjoying the fresh snacks. That night, I took out my journal to write about my day. I wrote about Mr. Carroll's smile, peaches for a hungry woman, my friends enjoying the garden's fruits, and Annie helping in ways. Taking time to be kind to others makes everybody feel good. Growing a garden and sharing the harvest helped me grow kind. How do you grow kind? So, let's think about some ways that we are kind. Thank you for watching, and we are going to be posting videos every day this week to celebrate Read Across America. See you tomorrow.